love. We all want to be, belong to a community or a group of people. And the moment your emotion is impaired, the moment your psychology is impaired, you begin to have issues interacting with people, so your social lifestyle is impaired. And so these three things are all together. You can't separate them. You cannot be emotionally okay and psychologically ill. It's not possible. You cannot be psychologically okay and you're emotionally ill. Mm-mm. It doesn't work that way. You can't say your social well-being is to its optimal best, yet you're having issues with your emotions, you're having issues psychologically. No, they work hand in hand. They are all together. All right, it's the same way you cannot say you are sleeping and then you have your eyes open. No, your eyes have to be shut for you to really say that you sleep. All right. Now, it also helps us to determine how we handle stress. Your mental health helps you understand how you handle stress, how you relate to others, and make choices. Mental health is important at every stage of life. From your childhood to adolescence, you need your mental health to be at its optimal best. You just cannot do otherwise. You cannot handle it otherwise. You need to be at your optimal best. And of course, over the course of your life, if you experience mental health problems, your thinking, your mood, and your behavior could be affected. Remember what I said earlier on, that your emotions, your psychological well-being, and your social well-being are intertwined. All right, and so in the course of your life, when you're thinking, which now is your psychological well-being, your mood, which is emotional well-being, and your behavior, which is your social well-being, will be affected if you experience any mental health problem. And so let's look at some factors that contribute to mental health problems. And some could be biological factors, such as genes or brain chemistry, right? Some people begin to have hormonal imbalances, and that begins to affect them. For some, it's about life experiences, trauma, abuse, you were raped, or you had someone come into your home, robbery and all that. That could create a form of trauma for you, and then you begin to have issues relating with people. For those who have gone through rape before, they begin to find it difficult to trust the other opposite gender. If a male was raped, you need to find it difficult to trust the female gender, or begins to see the female gender as an object, objectification. If the female was raped, she begins to find it difficult to trust the man. If you experience trauma in one way or the other, you may even find it difficult to pass a particular place in your area, especially if it happened at that time of the day or in an area that is similar. If you were robbed, for example, every noise that you hear in your house begins to frighten you and you can begin to have panic attacks. All right. And so these things, life experiences could bring that. Also, you could have family history. So mental health problems come about due to family history. It's just part of the family. One person has experienced it. Everybody is open or has a tendency of being prone to experience one form of mental illness or the other. So it's all complex, as it were, and we need to just pay attention to that. So that's a rundown of mental health. So let me say here that we have mental health problems. We have mental disorders, we have mental illnesses. Now, when you talk about mental disorders, you talk about things like OCD, obsessive compulsive disorder. You talk about eating disorders. Basically, a lot of them, you have disorders behind them, multiple personality disorders, bipolar disorder, right? You have disorders against those names when you're talking about disorders. And we talk about mental illnesses, right? We need to talk about things like schizophrenia. We talk about things like, let me take schizophrenia, for example. I'm trying to remember a number of their names now, but those ones are esophrenic and they require special care and special attention. Now, when you talk about mental health problems, there are depression as well. When you talk about mental health problems, then we talk about things like mild depression. If you talk about anger, if we begin to talk about fear, we talk about general anxiety disorder, right? We need to talk about a whole lot of issues that don't require hospitalization, that don't require medication, as it were. Anxiety, fear, anger, you know, and so on. So you need to understand those three categories. Now, all these put together, right, fall under mental health. So either you are mentally fit or you are mentally unwell. Let me state here that nobody is mad. The word mad is derogatory. You are mentally ill or you are mentally well. The same way you will not say that somebody is publicly, somebody who has malaria is mad. No, the person is ill. And so there's mental illness. There is nothing like madness or being crazy.